Comedian Basket Mouth breaks silence over EU dropping him as part of the team promoting, what will I call it now? Fighting against sexual harassment and all that. So
domestic violence against women.
Mm-hmm. So, I don't know. I felt some type of way about his posts. I can't put them in words right now, but I just know I felt some type of way. And I feel like when this happened, when he put out this statement years ago, he did not come out to apologize. Mm. A lot of people said so many things, told him it was wrong, told him, I mean, you're a public figure. As at that time, Basket Mouth was still very big, right? And they shared their concern and how they felt and how insensitive it was. But I can't remember clearly if he was silent or if he defended it, but I know he did not apologize. Mm. So why are you apologizing now that you're dropped from a platform like EU? Like, I think I like what is going on now, because it goes to let them know that what they actually do or what they say, people can hold them accountable for it. Because you cannot ignore people for that long, and just because the internet never forgets, like they put it, and they dug up this thing now, you feel like you have to come and tell us that you have two children, you have a wife, you have women in your life. Of course, we know you have women in your life. Some of these people who are rape apologists, which is what I would like to call
rape
them. Some
apologists.
Yeah, what I would like to call them sometimes. They have people around them, and most times when they make these excuses, the only thing that can get them to shut up is when you to make them know that this can also happen to your child. And the ones that have a little bit of conscience will kind of pull back and like, okay, so if this happens to my child, is this how we react? But, I mean, I hope that he understands the gravity of what he said.
You know, when that joke came out some years ago, I was actually one of those who took to Twitter to copy Basket Mouth and say something to him. I'm like, hey, you're going to have daughters. Mm-hmm. And I hope somebody also does the same thing to your daughter and they make you feel the scourge of what it is to actually trivialize rape victims, you know, those who have been raped. He did come out. He actually did come out to tender an apology then, but he was pretty diplomatic about it. Like, he was still trying to take a stance that people didn't understand it is comedy. You know, he was pretty diplomatic, but not an outright, unreserved apology like he's doing now. You know, he came out celebrating the women in his life. The most important people in his life are women. And it's quite unfortunate that one of a reputation, a repute like Basket Mouth, he's one of the biggest comedians we have in West Africa, I gotta say. You know, that you use your platform, your monologues and your dialogues to further strengthen what we consider advice against women. You know, and that's to let you know that the international community you're watching, you're not just within the small village called Nigeria. Spotlights on you. And it's quite saddening that EU had to drop him as one of the ambassadors, because you can't speak against what it is you're for. If your work is for this thing, then we can't have you work for us to speak against it. You know, it's pretty sad he's been dropped. The news out this morning that he was dropped as the ambassador. And that is to tell every other person that has a platform, you have a voice.
Oh, sorry to put this in. In that post, he also found a way to make us know that they are not even going to pay him for it.
Which is
because
still,
everybody was which is saying he lost money. Because and he's trying to, I didn't lose anything, I'm still fine. For me, and I'm going to look at it from the social media angle. I mean, it's good that's why this social media bill that is about to be passed, we just don't want it. Because social media has helped us help people accountable for their actions. If not for social media, it would have this thing would have passed and it would go and speak and that would be the end of it.
I still come back, jokes.
You know, and do you understand? If not that people had to like drag him and tag EU and like, no, this is what he has said and brought back the old post and no, will not be here right now. It would have still be on that list and would go and speak against what quote and unquote is for. Because if you made a joke about it and people are telling you that this is wrong and you're still taking a stance that
it was a joke. You didn't
maybe,
get a joke.
Maybe not, but I'm just trying to make people laugh. There are some things you don't joke about. You don't joke when people are being serious and you're just thinking that that's me. I'm just cracking jokes and you guys should laugh.
You just can't be cracking joke when you say, you know, that the woman doesn't have any say because you feel you've done some certain gestures for the woman and she's with you that night at home and then she tells you she doesn't want to have sex with you, that she doesn't have a right to say no over her buddy. You know, that joke was pretty expensive because I heard the joke, I saw the video, I'm like, dude, you don't say such. You know, and so other people took, there was even an artist, I'm not going to mention his name right now, that also told that same line to say, you know what, I took you out to the club, I spent money on you on drinks, and then we go back home, and you tell me you don't want to lay with me, that are you mad, fam? Are you mad, fam? Immediately, I called him, I'm like, are you kidding me? I'm like, so if it's because you spent a certain amount of money on a girl, she doesn't have right to say no, but it's her buddy. Mm. All right, and no is no. If she says no, it is no. There's no in between.
Yeah.
So Baskerman was definitely wrong about that joke he made. And he coming out to say what he's saying.
What he's saying now?
I don't think his apology is genuine.
I mean, he's coming out to let us know he's just losing money.
That's it.
Basically.
It's not even genuine, because if it was, you would have apologized then. Are you just realizing that rape is a bad
thing? And this apology could have been better if he's really sorry about it. He's not.
See, I feel bad about Baskerman. Whoever his PR team are, they didn't do justice with this. Coming out to tell the world that you're not being paid for.
He's probably
everybody want to be an EU, UN ambassador.
And activism is not about money.
It's not even about you being paid.
Everywhere you're going to go to speak against this thing, I'm sure they are going to foot your bills. There's something called per diem. They're going to take care of you.
Even if they are not footing your bill, what you're saying is that I'm not in support of domestic violence and I'm speaking for
it. And they'll use your platform.
Nobody needs to pay you.
I'm sorry, anybody on the EU, UN platform, you're on one of the biggest platforms anybody want to be on in the world. As a representative of the EU and UN, that is big deal.
That's a big voice.
That is you trying to make
undermine the platform.
Slight people still and undermine that platform. That after all, and people thinking I lost money, no, they're not going to pay me. It is not about that, bro. That is not what it's about. The fact that you made a mistake, genuinely apologize, and move on.
Be like Ayanana.
You know, it's not going to cost you anything. People respect you, and I'm one of those who respect Baskerman.
Yeah,
I
do.
Feel he's intelligent.
I love
He's one of the few intelligent comedians we have in Nigeria.
True.
Nobody can take that away from him. But bro, if you've been called out on a mistake you did, it's human to make mistake. Accept it, turn down a reserve apology, and be easy about it.
And there's always room to learn and unlearn. You might not understand it now. I'm sorry, but this is where I bring in what T.I. said on that Red Talk table. He said, at the time, I did not understand the sensitivity.
The sensitivity,
but now,
the gravity
I do. It's that simple. Nobody's saying you will know everything. I myself can come out tomorrow and say something that will make me make people feel uncomfortable. Mm. But it is important for me to take a step back, listen to them, understand their own pain, and understand where they're coming from, and apologize. You cannot tell a person how to react to what you say.
No, you can't.
Right? And this one, everybody's telling you, what you did is totally wrong. So I don't know what he's trying
to say. The EU is telling you what you did is wrong. The reason why they dropped you off.
Yeah, and I think everybody has a lesson to pick from this. Be careful what you put out on your social media, because you don't know who is watching and you don't know what's going to happen in future, and that word will be used against you.
Yeah.